And this same clause is in the American Constitution. Yet, governments will go to private banks and allow them to create the money. In 1934, in Canada, we were in the midst of a depression. We created a bank called the Bank of Canada, and it was given the right to create the money for Canada. And the money that was being created by the private banks was phased out then over the next 10 years. So what we really had was what was called legal tender. But gradually, because of the way the promise to pay money, check money, the banks got control of all of our money creation again through check money and promise to pay money, M2 money. We have the Bank of Canada Act of 1934, and it did spell out clearly that the government should create the money and the Bank of Canada should lend the money, not lend it, but spend it into existence for social and public projects. The United States, since the Federal Reserve Act of 1913, the creation of money in the United States has been totally in the hands of a private consortium known as the Federal Reserve Group. But we in Canada have the laws on our books, and the Bank of Canada Act has not been changed. The preamble reads the same. The clauses in the Bank of Canada Act are still there. The only thing that is lacking in Canada is that our politicians do not abide by the Act and do not force our government to print the nation's money. In Canada, all the shares for the Bank of Canada are held on behalf of the people by our finance minister, our federal finance minister. And he has final say by law on the creation of money for Canada. In the United States, they do not have that freedom. In the United States, the Federal Reserve is totally unaccountable to the people, and the politicians, many of them, have bought the idea that, the Federal Reserve, they're a government agency and they print it. But no, indeed, they print it, but they lend it to the government, and that puts the people in debt. And the mathematics of that is that the United States can never get out of debt. However, if you go through U.S. history, you'll find that way back in the 1850s, Andrew Jackson did manage to control the creation of money in the United States, and that is the only time in history that the United States ever was debt-free. But by law, if our politicians followed the law, we should never ever have a national debt, not especially Canada, where we have such a vast array of resources. We should want for nothing. Opened its doors in 1935, March the 11th, 1935, and immediately the Bank of Canada then started printing real legal tender that was printed on behalf of the people, and they started to end the depression of the 30s by sending out checks of legal tender then to the farmers across the West or to various places where people needed workers to pay the workers. And in my own experience, I know that my dad was getting $20 a month for grading a roadside, and this was real legal tender. And the depression in Canada started to come to an end at that point. So that was 37, 38. We were coming out of the Depression while other parts of the world were still burdened. During the war years, we actually created the third largest navy in the world. This was by putting everybody to work. And money represents what people create. Of course, we were destroying so much of what we were creating, but nevertheless, because we were using our own money, we did not go into any great national debt. And I have a chart here that will show the history of the Bank of Canada from its creation, or particularly from 1940, until it got to removed from proper use by the international banking cartel, and then our debt began to rise. Now, this is my history, actually, of my life. I was born in 1928, and I recall the Depression years, and the Bank of Canada was created, as I said, in 1934. The war started in 1939, and the government then was producing all the money that was needed to build the factories, to build the airplanes, and to build the ships. And as you can see by this graph, and this is from Statistics Canada, the figures, we did not peak high for a national debt. And once the war ended, the soldiers who came back were all put to work. They were either given a university education, free tuition, or they were given a VLA, which is a Veterans Land Act grant, to go into business or start a farming. And this was all money given on behalf of the people to the people who returned. And to keep everyone busy at that point, we built the St. Lawrence Seaway.